stable career path at a reputable agency and took a leap of faith and started Clairemont Communications, and she never looked back. The timing of this award couldn't be more fitting, as Dana and our team are about to celebrate our 10-year anniversary in 2020. I've been fortunate to work alongside Dana for the past 7 years and have seen the secret to her success. Dana is kind. She has a true passion for our profession and believes in going the extra mile to make great things happen for our clients. She works harder than anyone I know, is a great leader, mentor, and friend. Throughout her career, Dana has received several prestigious awards and accolades, including a PRSA Silver Anvil, the coveted Triangle Business Journal 40 Under 40 Leadership Award, and the TBJ's Women in Business Award in the Entrepreneur category. But I know Dana well enough to know this honor will mean the most to her because of her dedication to advancing the PR profession. Dana has always been a strong supporter of giving back to our industry and has always encouraged us to get involved in local and national public relations organizations. As a cornerstone in our industry, Dana has helped to shape the Triangle's PR and marketing community through bold entrepreneurship, innovative work, seemingly endless volunteerism, thought leadership, and compassion. And it's my great honor to present this year's Watt Huntley Award to our fearless leader and girl boss, Dana Phelps.
Years ago when Clairemont was hired to work on a new account, our clients were happy, joyful, positive people. Then I was asked to do a one-on-one call with their investor, who told me, Dana, the past is littered with dead bodies, people just like you. My point is, you have to have thick skin in the business and a determination to clearly communicate your message, whether that is, I have a great story idea for you, or let me assure you, you've made a smart investment by hiring us. PR also takes a lot of creativity regardless of your budget. I started my career working for a nonprofit, the Alabama Theater in Birmingham. When it came to pitch the summer film series, I put my news release in a popcorn box along with some candy from the refreshment stand and delivered these media kits to the local news outlets. I also took out the mail and answered the door at this first job, things I also do at Clairemont, because in PR, we do what it takes. In return, we are rewarded with some really amazing learning opportunities. When I was 26, I was the PR manager for Deltacom based in Huntsville, Alabama. I got to lead the communications for the company as it went through its IPO. I also created a community relations program that then allowed me to travel the Southeast to connect schools to the internet. In addition to getting to work with the technicians to pull the cable and do the actual wiring, I was commonly pitching the in-market media and serving as the on-camera spokesperson when TV stations arrived. Before that, I worked at a PR agency in New York where I was almost fired for being 7.5 minutes late one morning. I was living in a new place and I had never driven that route at that time of the day. I didn't anticipate school buses. I narrowly escaped being fired on the spot. My boss very sternly told me in PR, you always have to plan for the worst case scenario. Valuable lesson that still guides me today. When I was 30, I joined Nortel Networks, a 90,000 employee global company where, amongst other things, I was trusted with communications for mergers and acquisitions. This was a hard, fun, and crazy experience, mostly due to the confidential nature of M&A activity in a publicly traded company. It went something like this. I'd be sitting at my desk on, say, a random Tuesday morning, and I would get a call from my boss's admin. She would be whispering, Dana, I need you to have a bag packed on Thursday morning when you come to the office. You'll know by noon if you need to go to the airport at 2. Okay, Anita, where am I going? You know I can't tell you that. Okay, Anita, am I going to a warm place or a cold place? How many outfits should I pack? At Fleischmann Hillard, I got the opportunity to work with iconic North Carolina brands like Krispy Kreme, Cheerwine, and Cree, as well as travel to the south of France for my client Lenovo, with my client Lenovo to launch a leather laptop during the Cannes Film Festival. And it was during my time at FH that I began thinking about starting what is now Clairemont Communications. Social media was changing public relations, and that was really exciting. As we approach Clairemont's 10-year anniversary, social and digital continue to shape our industry. My son Jackson was 8 when I started Clairemont and was already showing signs of being an entrepreneur, and I think that gave me the courage to pull the trigger. When he was 10, he monetized his YouTube channel, and that same year he taught this guy that you might have heard of named Pent Holderness how to use YouTube. I will admit, Clairemont didn't start with much. I had a 1968 convertible Volkswagen Beetle that I loved, and I sold it to start the agency for a whopping $5,000. I always said I would get a new Volkswagen when the business was established, and I'm happy to say I currently drive the limited edition. Hashtag Pink Beetle. Jackson is now 18 and an aspiring filmmaker in Atlanta. Since he couldn't be here tonight, he interviewed me about being a business owner and winning this award. I planned to show the entire interview, but I didn't think through what might happen when you get a PR person and a filmmaker kid on a video chat. I'd love for you to watch it in its entirety tomorrow on ClairemontCommunications.com. And for now, I want to share one question he asked. And by the way, I didn't know what he would be